Good morning. Hey, I'm glad that you're here online with us to worship. Moody First and Moody Leon United Methodist Churches are again worshiping online because almost all of us are stuck at home. But I'm so glad that you're here. We're going to let some music play, and there's some instructions on the screen. But we want you to register your name down there, and we want you to make comments. This is an interactive service, and we are so glad that you're joining with us. But we want to interact with you. Since we can't be in person and talk to you, we want you to put comments down below, and we'll be commenting throughout the service with you. And we just want to engage with you this day, because this is the day that the Lord has made, and let us rejoice and be glad in it. And I am so glad to be here, and I am so glad that you're here with us online. And so we've prayed about this, and we've worked at it, and we're going to try to provide you an online worship experience that's close to what you get here. So just to look at the screen and enjoy the music for just a few minutes, and then we're going to begin our service. See you in just a few.
Let them see.
All right, so we're here again at this online worship service, and I would again like to invite you to make comments down below and just interact with people online. And we have just a few announcements. There's not too many because there's not much going on since we're all stuck at home on self-quarantine. So we have no Bible studies. There's no Sunday school. Obviously, we're doing worship online, and so we're going to continue that. I don't know for exactly how long. We do have some birthdays and anniversaries that we're going to do here in just a minute. We want to sing happy birthday to you. If it's your birthday, we are wishing you a happy birthday, and we're going to sing to you here in just a second. Also, our newsletters are not going to go out as normal since we can't gather to print those out and fold them up. We normally have a big folding party. So we're going to email those out. So if you would like a newsletter and I don't already have your email, just put your email address in the comments and we will send you an email, a newsletter. I forgot for a minute what I was talking about. But anyway, so we're going to do that. And so again, we're just really glad you're here. And if it's your birthday, I think Ed's going to lead us in a birthday song for you. Stand up and be proud it's your birthday, and let us sing happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, God bless you. Happy birthday to you.
All right.
Now I can turn my mic back on. Yeah. So, hey, and we have some wedding anniversaries. Did you have any, Dan?
I don't have any in the calendar.
Okay, well, if it's your wedding anniversary, also put that down there too, because it is a blessing to be married another year. And so God put families together, and we are so glad that you have been together for another year. If it's your wedding anniversary week, and we just want to say happy anniversary. So we're thrilled to be here, and we're going to sing now song 701. It's called When We All Get to Heaven. And so we need to be looking forward with hope to when not just this coronavirus pandemic ends, but in reality, we need to be looking forward to getting to heaven. And so we're going to sing about that. So Tammy and Ed are going to lead us, and Kathleen's going to play the ivory keys over there. And so we're going to have a good worship experience. And so I pray that you sing along. The words will be on screen.
And you do, you've got no reason not to sing out now. It's just you in the house. So stand up and sing out.
Amen.
And we all
time as normal at this point for our praise and prayer. So if you have a praise, write it down, put it in those comments, and let us hear it, because we need some good news right now. And you know, I've been looking online and seeing on Facebook and Snapchat and Instagram, and I've seen lots of good news. And so y'all keep it going. And if you have something that you've seen God move in your life this week, if you've seen something that you want everybody else to know about and we need to hear it, that uplifting news, put it in the comments. And also, if you have a prayer request, we ask that you put that down there as well. And so we're going to use this time of prayer. And so I would just like for you to take a few moments and just be in silent prayer with us. And then I'll offer a prayer. And then we will all close by saying the Lord's Prayer together. And so would you bow with me in prayer? Lord, what a blessed day it is. What a blessed day to know that you love us, that you care for us more than anything else, that you sent your own Son to die on a cross so that we could have a relationship with you. Father, we are forever grateful for everything that you've done for us. Lord, you have given us some really good things. The greatest of all that you've given us is the life of your Son. And Lord, you love us beyond all measure. And I pray this day that we love you in return, and that we love each other, that we give our hearts to you and to each other, that we look for places that we can serve and not just be served. Not for what we can get, but what we can give. And Father, the world needs you right now. The world is a little bit fearful and in panic, and experiencing something we've never experienced before with this coronavirus pandemic. And Lord, we continue to pray for the doctors and nurses that are tirelessly working for all of their patients. We ask that you give them strength and endurance and wisdom to know how to care for them. And Lord, we keep hearing about medicines that are helping. And Lord, I'm so grateful that you have provided those for us. But Lord, you can also heal just on your own. After all, you created us, and so you can heal us and make us whole and new and clean. And Father, we pray that you do that as well, that you protect those who aren't sick, that you watch over us, not only from the coronavirus, but Lord, from sin. It's even a more deadly thing in our life than that. And Lord, put your armor upon us from head to toe. Guard our hearts and our minds. Guard our families. And Lord, let us be always grateful for all that you have given to us. And for all those that have listed prayer requests, and for all those that we know about that are sick or ill, Lord, we pray for healing and peace and comfort that only you can give. And Lord, we have our hands out to receive the blessings that you freely give because of your grace. And Lord, we thank you once again that you would bestow peace upon this world, and that we would continue to receive grace upon grace. As we close with your prayer, Lord. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. And give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us of our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. So we have a responsive reading. This is the Apostles' Creed, and we're going to read it on screen. And so we are all going to read the whole thing together. And this has been said for some 2,000 years, and this is what we believe as Christians. And so I pray that you read it along with us. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. On the third day, he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. And I just want to make a caveat to you. If you read that Holy Catholic Church, and that's the first time you've read that, you notice that it's with a little c, and that just means universal. And so we know that the body of Christ is worldwide. And so that's all the apostles were trying to do there, is just say it's not local, it's global. And so I hope that you join us in this next song. What are we singing with me? Let's see, what do we have next? What a friend we have in Jesus. And isn't he a good friend? We need him now just like we've needed him every day of our lives. And so let's sing this. This time we have an offering, and we are bound to give generously because God has poured out his grace upon us, grace upon grace upon grace has he given. And so this is not just a time of for us to contemplate what monetarily with what monies we should give, but how should we give of our time, of our efforts, of our prayer life to each other. And so if you choose to give monetarily, of course we're not here and you can't put in the offering plate, so you can go to the bank on during normal business hours here at Moody First National Bank, and you can put just go up to the drive-in or go inside and say, here's my tithe, I want to put it in Moody First or Moody Leon account, and they will deposit it and you're good to go. Or you can go on the app called Venmo, V-E-N-M-O. I think that's close. Anyway, you can just go in there and search for Moody United Methodist Churches and give electronically if you don't want to leave your house, which is understandable. You can do that as well. So I just pray that you pray about how God is moving you to give in this time. And so we're going to have a choir special. Tammy and Ed are going to sing that for us. And so, and what's the song called?
He will be my God.
He is our God. And I hope that he is your God. And if he's not, I pray that you make him your God, your Lord, your Savior this day. But listen to this special music that they're going to bring to you now. Mm-hmm.
be my God. Oh, this life I'm living can at times be hard. I will trust Jehovah. He will be my God. He will be my God. He alone will be my God. Be my King, faithful forevermore by side. He will be my God. He will be my God.
Sing with us. We're going to have a video up. So let's sing along with us.
Oh,
Well, I'm glad you've joined us this day. We are so grateful that you're here. And I just want to know, have you ever had the camera pointed at you and you didn't know it? Has that happened to anybody? It's happened to me. And we've been quarantined at home, and so there's been some really good things that have happened in this time, and we've had some good family time, and the girls every now and then want to, well, they're 17 and 14 now, and so we did lots of videos when they were little, and so when they were babies and toddlers, because we wanted them to be able to look back and see what was it like for them to be a kid, and so they get to look back and enjoy that. And it's been a really great experience, and I've noticed some changes in the girls. It lifted them up. I mean, to see them as children, and how they were cared for, and how they loved each other as little kids. I mean, they still love each other now, but that's beside the point. But what I want to get at is sometimes the camera, we were filming the kids, but I would get in it inadvertently, or I could hear my voice. Most of the time, I was okay with how I behaved. But there was some of the time, I was like, really? You did that, Josh? That was not being a good dad, or that was not being a good husband. And I was disappointed in how I behaved. And so we're going to talk about this, and we've got it on the screen, is a behind-the-scenes look at grace. Because we all live in a life, this production called grace, this life that God has given us is filled with grace upon grace. And how are we handling it? How are we living it out? How are we giving away the grace that God has given to us? And so I think we need to take a look at that and take a look at our lives. And let's think about this for just a minute. I've got three cameras trained on me right now. But it's not the one that's important, because God is watching us. Every single move we make, every word we say, and not just that, every thought that we have in our heads, He knows it. And what's scary about it is He's already seen it before we ever do it. It's pretty sobering to think that there's a camera on you 24/7. I know it is for me. You know, when Tana was little, one of her favorite things to do was, we had a little camcorder and had the little viewfinder, and I could see it, or I could flip the lens around to see what I was seeing. Where the people that I was viewing could see it. And so her favorite thing to do, when she saw the camera in my hand, she'd run up to it and go, "Let me see, let me see, let me see." And she'd stand on her tiptoes and, you know, wave up there. And so I'd flip the viewfinder around so she could see, and she would just giggle and laugh. She thought that was the greatest thing ever, to be able to see herself on camera. But if we were to replay your life, frame by frame by frame, would you enjoy what you saw? And I think we need to really think about that. As we look at these scriptures, let's think about if our life is replayed before us, and it will be. God will replay our life before us, and He's going to ask us some very hard questions about our behavior. So will you enjoy the film? So let's look at these scriptures. As they're on the screen, you can see we're going to be in Ephesians 4, 1 through 6. We'll be in Philippians 2, 17, 2 Thessalonians 1, 11 and 12. And 1 Peter, we've got two in there, chapter 1, verse 23, and then chapter 3, verses 15 through 18. And so let's start with Ephesians. So if you go to Ephesians chapter 4, it says this. Well, as a matter of fact, let's pray before we read these words, because these are special words that God has given to us, and we need to pray that God uses them, that we use them the way God intended. Let's do that. So let's pray. Father, we're grateful for this day, grateful for the gift of your words. And Lord, we ask that you just simply help us to understand them, that you guide us through them, that you would help us see things that are hidden, that we would see with your eyes, that we would hear with your ears, and that we would love with your heart. For it's in Christ Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Ephesians 4, verse 1. Therefore I, this is Paul speaking, by the way, therefore I, prisoner for serving the Lord, beg you to lead a life worthy of your calling. For you have been called by God. Always be humble and gentle. Be patient with each other, making allowance for each other's faults because of your love. Make every effort to keep yourselves united in the Spirit, binding yourselves together with peace. For there is one body and one Spirit, just as you have been called into one glorious hope for the future. There is one Lord, one faith, and one baptism, and one God and Father, who is over all and in all and living through all. Now, I don't know about you, but those are some powerful words. And as I look here, Paul is begging. He says, I beg you, therefore, I, prisoner for serving the Lord, beg you to lead a life worthy of your calling, for you have been called by God. Did you know that you've been called by God to live out a production called grace? That your life is the production, and you're called out to live grace day in and day out. Well, now, why is that? It's because God has given us so much grace that He wants us to give grace away like there's not any tomorrow. And I remember in 1999, we were planning to get married in January of 2000, and we weren't sure if the world was going to end or not. They thought the clocks were going to go crazy and the electronics were all going to freak out because they didn't know how to go to the year 2000, and everybody was all up in arms about it. But it all turned out okay. We need to trust God that no matter what is coming, no matter what we're facing, like a pandemic, that God's got this. He has given us grace upon grace upon grace. He is in control, and so we need to let Him control our lives. And then when we view our lives, when we get to see the video of our life from God's point of view, we won't turn away because it will be Him living through us. But when we live our lives for ourselves, we'd rather crawl under a rock than watch that. So let's go to our next scripture, which will be in Philippians. And it's Philippians chapter 2, verses 17, and it says this. It says, but I will rejoice even if I lose my life, pouring it out like a liquid offering to God, just like your faithful service is an offering to God. And I want you to share that joy. It is a joy to give our lives to God. And He wants us to pour our lives out. And Paul's writing to the church at Philippi, and he's saying, pour out your lives like we pour out water or tea or whatever your favorite drink is. You pour it into a glass so that you can consume it. God wants us to pour out our lives for others so that they can consume what we're giving. Because we've all been given more grace than we can ever use up in this lifetime. And so we need to be giving it away. Behaving in such a way, as in Ephesians it says over here, it says, make every effort to keep yourselves united in the Spirit, forgiving each other's faults, living in peace. That's what He's asking us to do. And so if we move on to 2 Thessalonians, it says some really powerful things here too. 2 Thessalonians chapter 1, verses 11 and 12, and it says this, so we keep on praying for you, asking our God to enable you to live a life worthy of His call. A life worthy of the call. You have been called. You may be sitting there going, I haven't heard God call me. If He made you, He has called you. If you have been born, He has called you. And so it says here, so we keep on praying for you, asking our God to enable you to live a life worthy of His call. Did you catch that? God is the only one that can enable you, that can help you, that can fortify you, that can strengthen you, that can show you the way. He is the light at the end of the tunnel. He is your pathway. He is your strength in all things. He enables you to live a life worthy of your call. May He, that's God, give you the power to accomplish all the good things your faith prompts you to do. Then the name of our Lord Jesus will be honored because of the way you live, and you will be honored along with Him. This is all made possible because of the grace of our God and Lord Jesus Christ. It is God who is our strength. And so when we live this life for us, man, we mess it up. You know, I saw on Facebook the other day, and it said something like this. I may butcher it a little bit, but it supposedly comes from some cowboy, but I think they just do that to make everybody pay attention to it. It says half the problems in our life come from asking for things that God doesn't want us to have. The other half of our problems come from getting it. And so when we do our thing, what we want, we mess it up. But when we do what God wants, what He has directed, what He has given, it's a beautiful thing to watch. We pour ourselves out like an offering, just like you pour water into a glass. God has given us everything. Let us give everything to each other and to Him. And last, but certainly not least, we'll be in 1 Peter. We'll be in chapter 1, verses 23. And it says this, "For you have been born again, but not to a life that will quickly end. Your new life will last forever, because it comes from the eternal living Word of God." I'm going to read that one again because it's an important one. "For you," that means me and you, have been born again, but not to a life that will quickly end. Your new life will last forever because it comes from the eternal living Word of God. And that's Jesus Christ, by the way. He is the eternal living Word of God. You and I have been given life. We were created physically by Jesus Christ. We have also been renewed and given a new life by Jesus Christ. He has renewed our life. He's taken the old man, the old person, the old woman, the old boy or girl, and taken it away if you've trusted in Him, given you something brand new. And we'll go over to chapter 3, start in verse 15. "Instead of doing anything else you want, here's what you should do. Instead, you must worship Christ as Lord of your life. And if someone asks you about your Christian hope, always be ready to explain it, but do this in a gentle and respectful way. Keep your conscience clear. Then if people speak against you, they will be ashamed when they see what a good life you live because you belong to Christ. Remember, it is better to suffer for doing good, if that is what God wants, than to suffer for doing wrong." In verse 18, "Christ suffered for our sins once for all time. He never sinned, but He died for sinners to bring you safely home to God. He suffered physical death, but He was raised to new life in the Spirit." You know, God is so good to each of us. And in closing, I'm going to read the words to a hymn. This song is by Sanctus Real, and it's called "Lead Me." And I don't know if you've heard it, but I hope that you pay attention to the lyrics. I'm going to read this. It goes like this. "I look around and see my wonderful life, almost perfect from the outside. In picture frames, I see my beautiful wife, always smiling. But on the inside, oh, I can hear her saying, 'Lead me with strong hands. Stand up when I can't. Don't leave me hungry for love, chasing dreams. But what about us? Show me you're willing to fight, that I'm still the love of your life. I know we call this our home, but I still feel alone. And I see their faces, look in their innocent eyes. They're just children from the outside. I'm working hard, I tell myself. They'll be fine, they're independent. But on the inside, oh, I can hear them saying, 'Lead me with strong hands. Stand up when I can't. Don't leave me hungry for love, chasing dreams. But what about us? Show me you're willing to fight, that I'm still the love of your life. I know we call this our home, but I still feel alone. So Father, give me strength to be everything I'm called to be. Oh Father, show me the way to lead them. Won't you lead me? To lead them with strong hands. To stand up when they can't. Don't want to leave them hungry for love, chasing things that I could give up. I'll show them I'm willing to fight and give them the best of my life. So we can call this a home. Lead me, because I can't do this alone. Father, lead me. because I can't do this alone. I can't, you can't, none of us can do this alone. But God is willing and able and ready to give us His life. And He wants us to give ours away to Him so that He can lead us through this life. And then when you look back at this production, God calls grace, and you see your life, you won't look away because it will be God leading and moving and acting and living every moment of every day through you. And I implore you, if you haven't given your life to Christ, it is a relationship like none other. It's freeing. It's fulfilling. You're made blameless and holy and righteous, not because of what you've done, but because of what He did on the cross, and that He rose from the dead, and He is the eternal living Word of God, and He has given us life. Let us live it for Him and not for ourselves. Because there's a movie camera trained on you. It belongs to God, and it doesn't miss a thing. God's willing to wipe away all that we are, all the wrong that we've done, if we will just trust Him and believe. You know, the scriptures say all God wants us to do is believe. That's it. Believe. Period. Let us believe. Let us give our lives over to Him and be grateful for all that He has done. And because He has given us so much, let us pass it on. And so we're going to sing a song. It's not really an invitation. It's more of a, let's do this. Let's get out there. The church has gone outside the walls. Let's pass it on. We've got a fire in our hearts. Let's give that fire away and pass it on to all those around us. And Tammy and Ed are going to lead us in this hymn. And I pray that you sing this, that you mean it, and that you let God lead you where He wants and not where you want. I pray that you are blessed, that you are full of hope and peace and grace. Amen. Joined us today, that you were here with us. We are just thrilled that you were here with us, and I pray that you continue to make those comments down there and let us know what you need, what God is doing in your life, and that you're taking care of each other. And I just want you to know that God loves you. Even if it made you cringe when I talked about all the things that God can see and you thought about the actions that you take each and every day, and you're like, not sure I want to look at that. God can forgive every last thing you've ever done. He is there, arms out, waiting and ready. And I pray that you go out knowing that God loves you. He wouldn't have made you if he didn't love you. He wouldn't have sent Jesus if he didn't love you. He wouldn't have given us the Holy Spirit if he didn't love us. And so he is there waiting and ready for us to give our lives away to him so that we can give our lives away to each other. And I pray that you are blessed beyond measure by a God that wants to give and give and give some more. And so I pray that you have peace over panic, and that you have faith over fear. Be a mighty warrior this week. For in God's name, we ask it. Amen. Amen. Have a blessed week.